Everyone, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this session, we are going to discuss about the soft gelatin capsules. We will be discussing about the packing, storage and stability testing aspects of the soft gelatin capsules. We shall also be discussing its special application. If you are visiting my channel for the first time, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further search updates. If you want to view my previous soft gelatin capsules, you can visit the part 1 to part 4. So let us first try to analyze the packing of the soft gelatin capsules. When we talk about the soft gelatin capsules, they are actually fragile as compared to the hard gelatin capsules. So mostly they are packed into a well closed plastic or glass containers. Also, two things are very important which plays effect on the gel shell characteristics. The first is the effect of the temperature and the effect of the humidity. Soft gelatin capsules have the high amount of the plasticizer content as compared to the hard gelatin capsules. So if we try to differentiate between the soft gelatin and the hard gelatin capsules have a low plasticizer contain as compared to the hard gelatin capsules which contain 0.8:1 ratio. So in a vial which contains very hygroscopic capsules like of the soft gelatin shells, there have to be a substance known as silica gel or anhydrous calcium chloride which can absorb the excess moisture. So in some containers, glass containers or the plastic containers which contains the bulk amount of the soft gelatin capsules, desiccants are placed on the dead or they are swabbed up with the cotton so that the moisture is not able to penetrate through it. So when we talk about the packaging of the soft gelatin capsules, these plastic and the glass containers have advantages over the cardboard boxes since they are more convenient to handle and also they are more convenient in transportation as well as the protection of the capsules from the moisture and the dust. So to prevent the capsules from rattling, that is striking against each other, sometimes a tuft of the cotton is placed over and under the capsules in the vial. In vials containing very hygroscopic substances, desiccants like silica gel or other anhydrous calcium chloride may be placed to prevent the absorption of the excess of moisture content. It has been noticed that temperature as well as humidity has a huge impact on the stability of the soft gelatin capsules. They are more prone to the moisture absorption if they are exposed to high humidity conditions, whereas with the high temperature conditions they become more brittle. So nowadays capsules are strip packaged, which provides more better conditions of handling as well as ease in counting and the identification. So these are the packaging in which the soft gelatin capsules are generally can be done and packaged very well. For example, the plastic bottles which are widely used in US, the clamshell blister packaging whereby the one piece plastic that holds over and locks itself, and in this process no heating requirement is there. The other type of the blister packaging where heat seals the blisters on the cardboard. Then the other types of the packaging like the bucket of the capsules or the plastic pails of the capsules which contains the larger bulk packaging and is also economical in packaging as well. Moreover, these days plastic pouch ziplocked are also found at the retail stores. And these are the different kinds of the soft gelatin packing which are used for the packing of the soft gelatin capsules. So the physical stability of the soft gelatin capsules is primarily with the pickup or the loss of water by the capsule shell. So as the moisture rises, as the humidity rises, the capsule shell basically picks up and acquires the moisture, which causes the softening of the external shell. On the other hand, if the temperature rises, the shell loses the moisture and it becomes brittle. So the recommended storage conditions for the capsule is between 15 to 25 degrees Celsius and the relative humidity condition is 35 to 65 degrees Celsius, 35% to 65%. So this condition is designed to minimize the moisture absorption or the loss and the resultant changes in the physical dimensions during the encapsulation operation. So two things have to be kept up in mind. First is the effect of the temperature. Higher temperature causes brittleness in the capsule shells due to loss of the moisture. So the recommended temperature condition lies within 15 to 25 degrees Celsius, and the higher humidity conditions let the capsules absorb the extra moisture and the shell becomes more softer and pulpier. So the ideal recommended relative humidity condition is between 35 to 65% RH. So the storage of the soft gelatin capsules, there are no as such strict guidelines for establishing the stability testing of the soft gelatin capsules. The two guidelines which are of reference for the soft gelatin capsule storage is, first is the GCC guidelines for stability testing of the drug substance and pharmaceutical products, and the other guideline is the ASEAN guideline on stability study of the drug product. So both the guidelines stress out on testing of the certain characteristics such as appearance, color, order of the content, assay, degradation products, dissolution, microbial content, pH, leakage and pellicle formation. So when these tests are in process test as well as the finished product test. So they focus on the effect of the stability as physical stability as well as the chemical stability on accelerated storage condition as well as the long-term storage conditions. Since stability is very important as far as soft gelatin capsule is concerned. So when we talk about the stability testing for the soft gelatin capsules, we have to keep this table in mind, which clearly states that as the temperature rises above 21 to 24 degrees Celsius, the capsule, and the humidity rises above 60 degrees Celsius, the capsule becomes soft and pulpy. Whereas if the temperature condition is more than 24 degrees Celsius and humidity is more than 45 degrees Celsius, the capsule shell becomes brittle. So both the conditions, higher temperature conditions leads to brittleness due to loss of moisture, and the higher humidity conditions lead to the absorption of the moisture by the shell and it becomes soft and pulpy. So an optimum condition range, that is between the temperature conditions to 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. So the temperature should not be more than 25 degrees Celsius and humidity should not be more than 45 degrees Celsius is considered ideal. So humidity within 35 to 65 degrees Celsius. So in no case it should reach above the 60% higher humidity, and temperature above 25 degrees Celsius will be causing the brittleness in the capsules. So the following tests have proved adequate for determining the effect of the capsule shells content on the gelatin shells. The tests are strictly relevant to the integrity of the gelatin shells, and it should not be confused as a stability test for the active ingredient. So this temperature and humidity conditions talks about the stability of the testing of the soft gelatin capsules with respect to the temperature and humidity for the integrity of the capsule gelatin shell. So let us now try to understand and discuss the different applications of the soft gelatin capsules. The very first application is the enteric coated capsules. These capsules can be widely used for the enteric coating applications using the polymers such as cellulose, acetate, phthalates and the mixture of waxes with fatty acids or their esters. Then apart from that, they can also be utilized for the sustained release capsules, so they can deliver the dose over a prolonged period of the times. For this, they are first converted to the pallets, and the pallets are coated with the protective coating that delay the release of the drugs. Soft gelatin capsules are also widely used as suppositories and rectal capsules. Soft gelatin capsules can be used as a substitute for the rectal and vaginal suppositories, which can be pear-shaped. So in the figure also, you can see the rectal suppositories of the light green color. Apart from that, the soft gelatin capsules can also be used as an ophthalmic ointment. So ophthalmic ointments are sterile. To keep that ointment sterile during their storage and later use, it is required to be filled in a single dose container, which is intended for a single application to the eye. The capsule is punctured with the sterile needle and instilled into the eyes, and the shell is discarded. So these are the various applications of the soft gelatin capsules. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you do like my video, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates. Also, you can provide your views in the comment box. Thank you so much.